Hey there, you've probably seen my last video regarding enhanced weathering with basalt and you had some questions. And in this video, we're gonna dive right into it with the first question from Toby, who wanted to know if there's some sort of certification already in place like Vera Gold Standard, etc.
Regarding enhanced weathering in fields and the value for the CO2 markets, we are just not there yet to understand what's going on there exactly. We know that it works. We know that it happens. We don't know how fast it is. And we do not exactly know how to measure it right now. So there will be methods in the future, but we are right now developing them.
The next question is actually asked by two people, Axel and Jo. They wanted to know why we don't just build some sort of reactor that we plug on chimneys of industrial mills to capture the CO2 that they emit.
Of course, this is an idea that already exists. And there's at least one company that we know of that is already doing exactly this. There are, of course, advantages. If you do that, it's better than doing nothing. But if you just focus on trying to fix what is wrong, you're also not giving space to change the world into a better situation, that is to actually create an industry that does not do emissions. So in this case, you're just trying to fix a little bit of what you're doing, which is also not a totally bad idea. Yeah, but maybe the focus should be on changing things from the root. And in other hand, also the efficiency of this process is not 100%. So if you try to capture the CO2 that comes out of a smokestack, you will never be 100% successful in that.
The next question is the most popular one under this video, which was asked by four people, two by the name of Johannes, one Sebastian and Hans Sprühwurst. The question is about the potential of CO2 removal as well as the efficiency of the overall process, including transportation, milling and stuff like that.
For the process path from mining, milling, transport and application to the field, you need energy. Most of the energy needed is for milling the rock. Despite of concerns of most people, transport is not the large energy consumer here. If you use, for milling and the mining application, green energy, then there's no problem, even if the transport, fossil fuels like diesel will be used. In the future, I assume that the full chain will be powered by green energy, and then this is 100%. The potential can be harvested mostly to 100%, I assume. But still, if we use fossil fuel, we still would be negative.
I understood that it's not about the distance, it's about the grain size.
Exactly. Most of the energy is used for the grain, for the milling, yeah? And the finer you mill, the more exponentially more energy you need. So yeah. If you can show that you use the efficiency is the same as coarser grain sizes, then the better this is.
If it works like we expect and we use it on all fields, regardless of if it's actually working on depending on the soil, then we are in the order of magnitude of the emissions, and we'll have to cut the emissions by 70% or 80% or as much as we can. But then we are not a tenth or a hundredth of the emissions of the remaining emissions. We are in the same order of magnitude. Likely it will not be enough, but still it will be very helpful.
I love the next question by Pat Hussey, because he or she asks if any of us could just join in by spreading basalt on fields like community spaces, our gardens, golf courses, etc.
Yes, of course. Everywhere where you have plant activity, you have enhanced weathering, and you can do it everywhere where you want. The problem is just that it's very hard to calculate the carbon uptake. So if you, for example, drive with your car to the supermarket and buy some olivine and then put it in your garden, the carbon uptake will be less than if you go there by bike or whatever. So you can do it on your own everywhere you want. But the accounting is pretty hard, and I think you cannot sell any carbon credits.
Markus wants to know, how much CO2 do we actually have to remove in order to save the world?
So I think that's important to stress, that the more we will emit, the more we have to capture.
So the faster we cut emissions, well, the less capturing needs to take place.
Henny wants to know how enhanced weathering compares to other methods of negative emissions like biochar.
In the future, we will not compare, I think, biochar versus enhanced weathering versus soil organic carbon increase. In the future, the objective will be we have 1 square meter of soil and we will try to optimize the carbon capture potential. And this means somehow combining these methods in a most optimal way.
The positive effect of biochar with enhanced weathering is the fact that the biochar can potentially adsorb any metals or any toxic materials that are released from the enhanced weathering. Also, if you have the biochar, you expect to have better roots and better crop yields, so that there will also be more activity from microorganisms and from acids of the roots in the soil, which again will also speed up the enhanced weathering.
And last but not least, a very nice comment from Hof Gerken. They are seemingly pretty excited about this technology, as I am, and they want to know where to sign up and also express the idea of founding some sort of cooperative to make sure money actually ends up by the farmers and not gets lost somewhere in between.
Until now, there is not such an organization, but you can start at the local scale and wait until the carbon accounting scheme comes.
Stay tuned, it will come soon.
That's been it, but before you drop off, thanks for sticking around with me here. Could you please scroll down to the comments and let me know, just think about it 1 or 2 seconds, that's enough, if this video brought any value to you or if it's just unnecessarily filled space at Google's data center. Both answers are totally fine. I'm learning as we go here. Also, make sure to subscribe. I have a few fun projects in the pipeline. One of which includes this little toy car here, which is powered by a flywheel. So it's about a very old technology to store energy. If you don't want to miss that one, please make sure to subscribe. See you next time. Bye.